Hi, I'm Mark Garaway. I'm Director of Cricket at Millfield School. And we're currently in the brand new state-of-the-art indoor cricket school, which was opened in January 2020. As well as hosting all of our programmes and our events for our children here at the school, we also have external partners coming in, such as the ECB running their coach education courses at level 1, 2 and 3. And also we have umpires courses. We have county sides coming in here on a regular basis to take advantage of these incredible facilities that stand behind me. Part of what we have here for the indoor programme, which is so important because we spend 7 months a year inside because of the weather that we have in England, is to have five different levels of pitch inside this centre. So we've got two spin lanes, we've got a seam lane, which is directly behind me, and then two fast lanes, which are over here, which enable batters and bowlers to have to adapt to every condition that they're going to play in the game. Frequently asked questions about the Millfield cricket programme is, do you just cater for the top players? Well, the answer is no. We do that pretty well, but our main programme is around cricket for all. And that generally happens from January through to when we break up in the summer term. We have a session a week for anybody that wants to play the game, boys, girls, whatever age, whatever experience level and whatever ability level, there's something for everybody here at Millfield Cricket. On the performance side, anybody who plays county age group cricket and above, and that can include academies and even people that are playing professional cricket by the time that they're in their last couple of years here at the school, get access to our five professional coaches over the course of a week. Three are full-time, and two are private coaches. And then myself, as director of cricket, will lead up the batting, the fielding, and the wicket keeping. We have Dan Hellesvay, who's also worked for the Surrey Stars in the Kia Super League, who runs the fast bowling programme. And Jack Moore, who works for Somerset County Age Group squads as one of their managers and coaches, he leads the spin bowling programme. There'll be timetabled sessions, there'll also be squad sessions, there'll be skill set sessions, which takes the keepers, the batters, the fast bowlers and the spin bowlers in their own specific groups before school every day of the week. And you get lots of access points throughout a week. None of those winter sessions are obligatory. You can come into those as and when you want to develop your game. The performance programme players have the opportunity to practice within timetable here at school. We have something called the rotation card, and if you're a county age group player, then it means that you will rotate through your non-core subjects, subjects like music, PE, product design, for example. And we'll rotate around those, so we get one specialist session with you in timetable every week, and then it won't affect the sort of flow of your academics within any given subject. If you are an academy player or an emerging player programme player or an international player, then you have the option of dropping a GCSE block and replacing that with cricket. And in that context, you have six lessons over a two-week period. You will have three technical sessions, one tactical session and two gym sessions with our excellent MISWA staff, MISWA being the Millfield Institute of Sport and Wellbeing. The gyms, as you will know from looking around the school on the virtual open day, are absolutely magnificent here, and they are staffed by the most outstanding S&C coaches, many of which who end up going from this environment straight into county cricket with the likes of Surrey and Hampshire after working within this environment alongside Millfield Cricket for a couple of years. For our performance players, they're often called away and given opportunity to play in a number of games for their counties, for their regions, over the course of the summer term. And the summer term obviously is very busy in terms of exams, but also our cricket here. We have a policy that any time that somebody gets called to play a county age group game, a second 11 game, a minor counties game, then we will release them from our fixture if there is a clash on the same day. The only time that doesn't happen is if we have a national cup match. What this has enabled us to do is to allow the players to spend more time with their counties during the season. And we've noticed a real upturn in a number of players that then go on to be selected and given professional contracts at the end of their time here at Millfield. At the moment, we're averaging between two and three players out of each cohort that leaves here in Upper Six that goes directly into the professional game. And for those that don't, that still want to try and pursue the professional game, there's the option of going to universities through the MCCU programme there, and we've got great links in particular with Cardiff and Oxford, and a number of our players have ended up going there and then progressing into the professional game. And then another outlet which is becoming increasingly popular is going over to Australia through our links with the Joe Root Academy for them to join up with the high performance programme in Adelaide. And we've had 31 cricketers over the course of the last 10 years that have joined up with a programme in Adelaide at the end of their time with Millfield. Some use that as a gap year, some use that as an extra training opportunity before they go into professional cricket. All of those avenues are well established here at Millfield. Another thing that we do here at Millfield is develop people not just in terms of their cover drive, their fast bowling, their fielding and their catching, but also as coaches. And in our sixth form programme, we encourage our players to go on level ones and level two courses to make sure that they're able to coach as well. We then deploy them within our own programmes here at school and also into the external partners that we've got around us at cricket clubs, within All Stars programmes and Dynamos programmes, also with the Super Ones Lord Taverners Disabilities programme that we host here at the school, and many other things besides. So they get a whole rounded education of cricket, not just that of being able to hit a ball, catch a ball and bowl a ball. We have some fantastic partnerships at Millfield. The ECB have recently hosted their Bunbury Under 15 Regional Festival down on the grounds. We had England and Australia women's teams playing as part of their preparation for the Ashes in 2019 out on our magnificent and iconic main ground here at the school. But we also are linking up with the Joe Root Academy as well, who are going to be hosting their holiday courses here over the course of every summer, Easter and Christmas courses. Our coaches are also involved in that. Our players will be allowed to come onto that, obviously, but we're opening that up to the bigger market to bring more people through the gates to experience our wonderful facilities, our fantastic environment and our brilliant coaches. So sitting behind me, we have pitch vision technology. We have that in lanes 1, 3 and 5 in our indoor centre. And basically every ball that you bowl or bat against in those lanes, you can have videoed and filmed. You see some TV screens behind so you can check on your progress as you're playing. But more importantly, all of that feedback goes onto your mobile phone, onto an app, which means that you can review and reflect on your performances at any stage that you want throughout any given day, as opposed to just within the training session that you have inside the centre. Linked to this system in here for our training environment, we also have two pitches outside that have got pitch vision match technology. And again, every single time that you hit a ball or bowl a ball in a game of cricket, that will go onto your profile, which builds up a huge amount of information for you to work with your coaches and your external coaches and parents to make your game even sharper than it was before you came to Millfield. The indoor centre here is the first of its kind anywhere in the world. We have different surfaces underneath the floor, which enables a ball to react differently from a bowling point of view, and then obviously for the batters to react against. We have two spin lanes over here where the ball is a little bit slower off the surface, but turns and bounces. Just behind me in lane 3 here, we have the seam lane. So this one nips about a little bit and replicates English conditions. And over in the far two lanes, there's a little bit less seam movement and more pace and bounce. And those are more sort of South African and Australian wickets. So the idea really is that you can go across 5 lanes over the course of a session, having played in the subcontinent over here in England, and then in Australia and South Africa over here, which enables us to be adaptable to any condition that we might face within the game. Underneath my feet, we have the fielding area. This is 4G grass, which enables us to be able to dive around indoors, which is something that's been unheard of unless you put mats down. The challenge with mats is obviously that the ball can hit the front of a mat and veer up, causing damage to people's faces, hands. But in here, we've got a fantastic facility where people can fling themselves full length and the grass will absorb the impact just as it does outside. There's nowhere in the country that has this built into the centre at the moment, so we're the first of its kind. And exactly the same for the type of flooring that we have under every wicket as well. So you will be able to develop your game at an accelerated rate and one that is instantly transferable to the outdoor conditions that you will play in every summer. Our touring programme is also something that we take a lot of pride in. Every other year we take 3 squads, an under 16 team, an under 18 team and a girls squad, away to various points around the world and play a number of fixtures on international grounds all the way through to some club grounds. So we have 6 games for each team. Every player will play at least 5 times on the tour, but around that we put training opportunities in different spaces with different coaches to increase that knowledge base that we have as cricketers, but also put educational and cultural elements around each of the players whilst we're out there too. So for example, in India, we had a coaching session where our children and the parents that came out, as well as the coaches, worked with some slum children from the Magic Bus charity over there for 2 hours on the maiden oval out in India. It's one of the best things that we've ever done within Millfield cricket, and we replicate that everywhere we go. Charity is a massive part of Millfield cricket. We've raised over £40,000 in the last 4 years to go to a number of different charities, ranging from Help the Heroes towards a trust that was set up in memory of one of our old Millfieldian players who sadly passed away a few years ago. Our new charity that we're about to link to is the Ruth Strauss Trust, named after Andrew Strauss's wife, who sadly passed away a couple of Christmases ago. The trust is set up to support people that are going through rare forms of cancer, and also to support the families as their mums and dads are going through that process, in exactly the same way as Ruth and Andrew were supported as they went through. So that's our big charity drive for this year, and it's fantastic that our management group, which is called the Cricket Council, which is a pupil body, will be pushing a lot of emphasis and effort into developing ideas and initiatives which will raise funds for the Ruth Strauss Trust over the coming year. Well, thank you for being at our virtual open day around Millfield cricket. And if anybody has any follow-up questions around the content that you've seen, then please feel free to email me and I'll answer that in as expedient fashion as I possibly can. Many thanks.